It's Friday night, and live on 2K Sports, we're going to bring you the NBA in all its excitement. We'll see Las Vegas facing Pittsburgh. This is Kevin Harlan along with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry. David Aldridge will be reporting from the sidelines. Tip-off goes to Las Vegas. Here are the starters for Las Vegas. We've got White. Also, Alan Crabb is out there. Swanigan is out there with Chandler Parsons. And it's Bolden in at the power forward.
Nice effort taking the early lead. Here we go.
Take a nice deep breath. You score on that first possession. Gets the game started the right way.
Now, here is Morris. Smyelagic. White covering. Four on the clock. From deep. Pittsburgh gets it back with a new 14. Here's Zizic. Out to Morris. High arcing shot, and that's 2 points on the layup.
And it's all about the release when you shoot the floater.
White the pass to Crabb. Here's Swanigan. Fires from 18. Forbes with the rebound.
That might not be the shot they want him taking, even with the D backing off.
Morris inside. White covering. Morris with the bucket.
And say what you will about the value of the three-pointer, but those close-in looks are always plan A. Every trip down, get to the paint, get deep, score.
And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
The athleticism and blinding speed White possesses is impressive. This guy plays with a lot of moxie.
Las Vegas shooting their first free throws of the game. First free throw is good. He's perfect from the line this time. Morris with the ball. Pittsburgh shooting their first free throws of the evening.
Monte Morris.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Both good from the line that time. Here's White. We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Parsons looking it over. Back to White. Pass to Swanigan. Pittsburgh pulls it in.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough.
And how about the awareness Hunter possesses? Understands when one of his guys has an opportunity.
So it's Las Vegas now after Pittsburgh's three-pointer at the other end. Their offense has been great here.
Yeah, the ball movement has been terrific, and they've kept the defense off balance. No one to blame on that one but himself. You get looks like that, you've got to take advantage.
First quarter of play. We're about 3 minutes in. Six to shoot. Now here's Cram. He's guarded closely. He can't get that one. Pittsburgh leading by five. Morris dishes to Hunter. And Forbes kicks to Morris. The pass to Forbes. They grab their own miss. That one goes. Count it. Morris has got 8 points.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
And first time out of the game called for Las Vegas.
And doesn't like how things are going right now.
The timeout before the timeout here, maybe just to cut off the momentum and have a chit-chat with the team to settle down.
Vegas. Brown is checked in for Chandler Parsons. Pat Connaughton comes in for Alan Crabb. And Corey Joseph subbed in for White. Here's Swanigan. No points in the game yet for him. Joseph, the pass to Brown. Here's Swanigan. They could use a bucket. And it's Brown missing. Last outing for Pittsburgh, it was a loss to the Celtics in Boston. And it's blocked. Let's it go with a three. Here with the rebound. Pittsburgh leading by seven. Off with the layup.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
Here's Brown. He's off on that one. O'Neal with the defensive effort. Down low, Hunter. And the layup's good off the glass.
With a number of moves and shots to choose from, Hunter is scary. Nice bucket there.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
.104 left in the first quarter. Six on the shot clock. The three from Joseph. Las Vegas again missing. Bembry. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Pittsburgh working the ball around. Wagner passes to Trier. And here is O'Neal. Knocks down the three ball.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Yeah, if you walked in at any point during this game to watch 5 minutes of play, one team played harder. We know who that was.
Here's Joseph after Pittsburgh's three-pointer at the other end. He kicks it to Brown. Here's Swanigan. Las Vegas again missing. Here's Bembry. Shot from the wing. And the last shot before the buzzer is off. And it's Pittsburgh enjoying a 12-point lead as they talk things over during the break. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. Glad to have you with us, folks. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. And guys, when you consider how Pittsburgh is doing, your thoughts?
I mean, the rebounding was the difference in that first period. You've got to block these guys out.
Yeah, rebounding can also be just about will, and they showed some of that in going in there and collecting some boards.
Pittsburgh leading by 12. And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. And Pittsburgh looking at who they've got out there. They've got O'Neal, Trier out there with Richardson, and it's Wagner in at the center position. Now here's Joseph. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Bolden, good.
And I do so enjoy watching a bounce pass executed that perfectly.
Here's Trier. He's covered by Joseph. Pass to the Bembry. To the middle. Here's Wagner, and he dunks it down.
And really a good job spotting his teammate near the bucket and then just pinpoint passing for the finish.
We play just over a minute of basketball here in the second quarter. Here's Joseph, and he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. For Las Vegas, they've been perfect at the line so far, albeit just two for two. And that one misses. So for Las Vegas, Chandler Parsons comes in for Jonah Bolden, and Crabb subbed in for Pat Connaughton. And the second free throw, good. And so it's Morris with it. He'll bring it up for Pittsburgh. Pass to O'Neal. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2 for 2 from the floor.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
Joseph, the pass to Crabb. Here's Abrines, guarded by O'Neal. And it's Monte Morris with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. You know, Brent, how candid can players be in their answers in the post-game interviews about what has happened or what they're feeling at that time? In other words, is there a danger to being too honest as a player?
There could be, Kevin. I mean, anytime you express some of your vulnerabilities, and if it's done at the right time, somebody's going to take advantage of it. What we've seen over the past couple years is, forget about when it is that the media is asking you questions. Most players are taking it to their social media accounts where they're able to get the message out without being baited by somebody with regards to a question. They can expound on whatever it is that they are feeling at that time, and that helps them to control the messaging a little bit more. And I think that trend is going to continue to grow.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And the shot goes in.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash mouth physical basketball, guys.
Now here's White. Passes it to Swanigan. Pulls it up. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him.
An assertive offensive player, White knows he has the green light to rise and fire.
It's Richardson on the wing, covered by Parsons. Back to Richardson. 5 on the clock. 3-pointer. That shot, no good. And it's Las Vegas the other way. Teardrop shot, and out of bounds as Pittsburgh gains possession.
Yeah, and I think he was surprised to see that pass coming his way and just really reacted too late.
Hunter's checked in for Malachi Richardson. And Las Vegas making a change here as well. Brown's checked in. Pittsburgh leading by 10. And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. Now the pass to Hunter. Shot clock at 6. Here's Forbes. And that's a foul called on Ante Zizic. That's his first foul. Las Vegas trails by 10. Now White. But three. Offensive rebound.
Plus 8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Here's Hunter. That one falls. His second basket of the game. He's now 2 for 3.
And one thing about Hunter, he never gives up. You can see the focus and energy that he plays with on every possession.
Now here's Parsons. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Another shot and foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that. That's your only option.
Las Vegas shooting their 5th and 6th free throws of the game. First free throw is good. So for Las Vegas, Jonah Bolden's checked in for Parsons, and it's Pat Connaughton in for Crabb. And so he hits both.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
1:27 left here in the second. Pass to Hunter from outside the arc. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Hunter's got 5 points now in the quarter.
A very consistent 3-point shooter. Hunter shoots it well from there because of how confident he is.
Bolden can't get it to go.
That's the only kind of defense that's going to cut the mustard here tonight. You got to stay on top of a guy like that who can play at such a high level offensively.
Now here's White. And it's Connaughton atop the key. Jacks up a 3. Pittsburgh pulls it in. Forbes has got 4 rebounds in this game. All alone. But they get it back. Here's Wagner. Here's Trier. Swanigan pulls it in. Swanigan's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Fades and shoots. Las Vegas again missing.
Yeah, that miss might stick with them for a little while. That's kind of a shoot-around jumper if I've ever seen one.
And so we wrap up the first half. It's Pittsburgh. They lead by 13. We'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it. For Pittsburgh, and big fella, let's get your thoughts on the home team.
The area where they impressed me the most has been on the boards. When the shot's going up, everybody goes for it. Just a matter of maintaining that energy, playing with that same kind of aggression in the final two quarters.
How about you, Kenny? What did you think about the visiting team?
Their inaccuracy from behind the arc was brutal. Shot selection, I didn't see any. The perimeter offense they're running, you could scrap that. They need to get back to the basics. Pound it inside, more pick and roll. Try to pick up some easy buckets in transition.
And that's a wrap. With the third quarter approaching, we now send you back to Kevin and the crew.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. You look at Monte Morris. He's been really playing well.
Definitely been challenging the defense here early on, not settling for anything outside.
And you want these kind of nights where you can start to see those openings before they happen.
And with the big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. On the court right now for Las Vegas, they've got Swanigan, Alan Crabb out there with White. Then there's Chandler Parsons, and it's Bolden in at the four-man position. Pass to Hunter, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It goes on Chandler Parsons.
And there, just through activity, Hunter keeps the pressure on the defense.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
At the line for two.
The free throw drops for Hunter.
An athletic forward with a versatile skill set. Hunter has also proven he can come up big in big moments.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots. So it's Las Vegas now. 15-point game. And here is Crabb. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Outside, White lets the three fly. Hunter grabs the miss.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Yes, that goes in.
And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
Now here's White. Now the dish to Crabb. To the paint. Here's Bolden and the powerful one-handed slam.
They've worked hard to get this lead. Can't start giving up easy slams all of a sudden.
GA, that's right. And that was easy. Gift wrap for him.
So much talk about 48 minutes. The team with the lead letting its guard down now.
Awesome concentration there. When Hunter's committed to scoring, he's hard to stop.
Las Vegas calls timeout.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let them hear about it.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it, make the adjustment.
And Pittsburgh with some changes. O'Neal's checked in for Hunter, and it's Richardson in for Bryn Forbes. And Las Vegas making a change here as well. Joseph, he's checked in for White. Bolden passes to Parsons. Here's Crabb. Basket good. Crabb's got his first 2 points.
And for a player who's so prolific from beyond the arc, Crabb has the length and some hops inside to beat you.
Morris against Joseph. Morris passes to Zizic. Richardson outside. Four on the shot clock. Takes the three. Pittsburgh gets it back with a new 14. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
And not wasting any time here, kicking their offense right back into gear. That's 3 of 4 from the field.
Passes it to Crabb. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. The pass to Bolden. And that one goes long.
And if that's the best look you can get on a possession, what a waste of a trip down the floor.
Yeah, see the coach? He's got that frown on his face. I think we know why. Not a high percentage look.
Richardson for three. And so the ball is out of bounds. Richardson touched it last. Pittsburgh making a switch here. Wagner's checked in. And then for Las Vegas, Pat Connaughton, he's checked in for Caleb Swanigan. And Alex Abrines subbed in for Alan Cramp. Las Vegas trails by 17. Joseph looking around. Parsons outside. Outside, Joseph. Here's Bolden. Money from the wing. Bolden's got 8.
And the shooting has really been there for him today, but he may have to take it upon himself to continue to carry this team and try and get out of this hole.
Morris outside. Pass to Wagner. Fade away. Offensive rebound. O'Neal. No good with the layup. And so it's Parsons with it. He'll bring it up for Las Vegas. Down by 15. Joseph, that's good.
He knew what he wanted to do all along. The teardrop.
Joseph against Morris. That's tipped, and he's able to get it back. Smiley. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk. 1:52 left to play in the third. Joseph, the pass to Abrines. Kicks it to Parsons. Shot clock at 5. Back to Abrines. Over Richardson. Abrines' shot is off.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Down low. Here's Wagner. Joseph with the rebound.
Shot didn't fall, but that play worked well to get a good look at the basket.
Yeah, an efficient offensive possession. They found the look that they wanted, just didn't go in.
Here's Bolden. He's got 8. Parsons dishes to Joseph. Parsons against O'Neal. And Parsons kicks to Joseph. Floats one up. Can't hit that one.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there. And that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
Morris passes to Wagner. Richardson against Parsons. 20 feet out. Richardson, good. And Pittsburgh leads by 17.
Oh, check out the handles. Their nasty spin move had his man grabbing for air.
Parsons for 3. And that shot was up in time, but doesn't go in. And it's Pittsburgh out in front by 17 points at the end of the quarter. They've been putting on a clinic in the paint. Shots are falling with regularity, and they are pounding it down low. Back to the action after this word. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for him.
Well, there's a way to break down the defense with the handle. You can do it with the pass. Prime example of that right there.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. Wagner out there with Hunter. And it's Trier in at the shooting guard position. Parsons' shot is off. Pittsburgh leading by 17. Here's Bembry. And he uses the glass on the layup. Bembry's got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for Pittsburgh.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
Here is Forbes, light covering. And Forbes kicks to Hunter. Here's Trier. Now, here's Hunter, covered by Parsons.
Well, he had the perfect opportunity to finish that one, guys, and just flat out blew it.
Here's Brown, softly drops in the floater. Brown's got his first basket.
Wow, he doesn't make plays like that very often. That's a nice move inside.
Trier from long range. It's rebounded by Las Vegas.
And he has not made one shot in this one. Has to be on his mind every time he's pulling up.
White looking around. Pulls it from the elbow. And that one drops.
Beautiful touch there. Give White these types of looks consistently, and he's going to make you pay.
Here's Trier. Pass to Bembry. Hunter kicks to Bembry. Pittsburgh needs to get off a shot here. Count that bucket. And Pittsburgh leads by 17.
There you go again. A nice kick out after the D had collapsed on it.
White finds Parsons. Back to White. Brown, the pass to Parsons. Here's Connaughton. Second chance shot, and the layup is up and in.
Timeout.
These defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
Now a timeout called by Pittsburgh. Checked in for Pat Connaughton. He has a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. Pittsburgh's head coach talked to his team during that timeout. His point to them was that they put themselves in the position to succeed and that this is their game to lose. So he needs to see full concentration out of every guy on the court to finish this one off. Kevin?
So it's Las Vegas now after Pittsburgh's three-pointer at the other end. Now here's Cram. Brown outside. Passes to Parsons. Puts it up from 15. Pittsburgh pulls it in. Hunter's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Here's Bembry. White covering. Forbes the pass to Hunter. Off target from 3-point range. Las Vegas trails by 18. And the pass to Swanigan. And he gets the whistle for the 3-second call.
And that is just a deflating error on his part.
Yeah, he knows he shouldn't have made it, and that's just really overall a frustrating sequence that hopefully doesn't stick with him.
Morris is checked in for Bemper. And Las Vegas making a change here as well. Bolden's checked in. Now here is Morris. Smiley. And he drops it in from the low post. And Pittsburgh leads by 20.
Give them credit. They've worked hard all game, now looking to finish it.
No, great job of getting in position to win a game. It's been an all-out effort from the squad.
Here's Swanigan. Grab up top. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim.
Well, Crab's a shooter. If he gets his feet set, nice 1-2 hop like that, it's going through.
1:30 left in the game. Here's Zizic, and the wide open shot for Morris. Good on the triple.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for Pittsburgh.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget, and on the other side, one that I think most will try to forget.
And on the year, this will turn out to be win number 34 for them.
No doubt they came in very motivated to win this one and finish the season series at a game apiece.
And a lot of players tonight helped contribute to this performance, but in particular, a real good game it was for DeAndre Hunter.
He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. Definitely had the hot hand.
And Parsons, no good on that one. Of course, Dirk Nowitzki spent his whole career with the Dallas Mavericks.
We don't see that much anymore, do we, from the beginning to the end with one team?
No, but I think we're going to still occasionally have anomalies like we did with Reggie being in Indiana for the years of his playing career. Nate McMillan was in Seattle for his playing career, now coach of the Indiana Pacers. So there will be times where we'll have that once or twice. It's not going to happen very much, Kevin.
Not in today's
NBA.
Not
in today's game and not with what's at stake.
Here's Smith after the basket by Las Vegas. 29 seconds left in the fourth. Pass to Zizic. Over Parsons, and there's Pittsburgh with another bucket.
Making every effort to put this game on ice.
You love that the guys are staying aggressive late in this ball game, just not wanting to let go of the rope.
Inside, whoops, anticipated the pass, turnover. Hunter with it. So it's Pittsburgh picking up the win. It was a tale of two teams tonight, one that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go, and once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
And that'll do it, folks. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Alder, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. So long and good night, everyone.